Jambo, Jambo!
Jambo, Jambo.
My beautiful friends, our beautiful friends, we are now in tropical
Zanzibar.
Zanzibar. It is amazing. This is our second day. I didn't vlog yesterday because we basically didn't do a whole lot.
Kind of tired as well.
Yes, we were kind of tired of the trip. It was a long flight, a long day. I bought a GoPro to be able to show you much more of Zanzibar, and I played with it yesterday in the swimming pool. And in the sea. Now we can vlog even better. So from now on, I will show you a bit more of Zanzibar. I'm trying to film you as well. So probably this is a bit of a weird angle. You are just so much taller.
Should I hold it?
This is a bit weird as well. We're basically here to get some rest and for the nature, the sea, snorkeling. We can't wait. But we will begin our trip with some culture, getting to know the island a little bit more and the people. So we will go to Stone Town, and apparently the island is famous for its herbs, so we will also do a little tour there. Yeah.
And some fruits? Some exotic fruits, that was the word I was looking for.
Is it? Yeah. Yeah.
Ooh, we can taste it, so we can show it.
Yeah. Yeah? I love fruit. Market, which is just one crazy, hot, messy, stinky business. And it's about, what is it, 37 degrees? And then all of a sudden you have the sea. Yay! Sing the Jambo Jambo song.
Yeah, Jambo. La 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 la.
And then you have this. Beautiful. What a difference, eh?
Oh, yeah.
So much chaos right over there, and then just serenity right over here. I wish I could swim in there right now. But it's beautiful though. I'm glad we did it because you see life much more. I have the feeling that my sunglasses are crooked. We're looking so good, honey. We're cooking.
Yeah. Pretty hot.
We're now at the Maru Maru Hotel having lunch with a pretty nice view. This is the city from above. So look, there you see a dhow, city wall. Okay, so we're now in a spice farm and I'm gonna teach you basically how things grow. So here's lesson one. This is how a pineapple grows. Ta-da! How awesome and weird is that? So can you guess what grows in this tree? Take a closer look. It's one of my favorites ever! Avocado! Look how cute this is, by the way. We will get all our spices in here. So this is like the dried one. Now we got this.
Mambo!
Jambo!
Mambo!
Mambo! Mambo! Mambo. And now we can taste it.
Whoa.
This is also used for toothpaste.
Yeah.
You recognize it. And this This is lemongrass. It smells delicious.
This is really cool, so I need to share this. This tree is cinnamon. I just took this piece of wood.
Slice it off.
If you smell it, you instantly smell cinnamon as well. So, like, the cinnamon sticks don't really exist. And then the roots of the tree, I feel like a nature documentary maker.
Steve Irwin.
The roots of the tree is this, and this is Vicks. When I smell this, it actually reminds me of my colds, you know, if you rub it over your lungs. That's like the root of the cinnamon.
Ta-da!
Amazing.
Very cool. For me, this is the perfect example of the power of nature. I feel very much at home here.
Hakuna Matata! Welcome to Zanzibar, Mr. Butterfly! Hatia! Welcome to Zanzibar!
Coca-Cola.
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 You can't get it fresher than this, right? Little conclusion, I thought the tour was very nice. The city though is just exactly what I thought it would be, just one big mess, smells like crazy. But at the same time, I'm very glad that I got to see it, and the spice tour was perfect, really nice. It was just such a long day though, right?
Yeah.
We're so tired right now, all we want is just
chill, drink, get some bites, and dive in the pool.
And therefore, we have good morning, everyone. We are now in the Jozani Nature Reserve. We're gonna see some monkeys today. I don't really like monkeys though. I'm not really fond of them.
So if you keep silence 1 minute.
Peace.
You can feel it.
Yes.
How the natural environment is. No cars, eh? No plane on top.
We both thought that it was a little bit too touristy. So when you see one monkey, you see like 1,000 people around it. But it was really a pretty forest. And it was quite cool to see the monkey though. It's like a unique species that only live in Zanzibar. So I thought it was really nice and serene somehow. The forest is really pretty and quite calm. But not so calm anymore when you see a monkey.
True story.
And we're sweating.
Look at my chest.
Oh, guys. Way too hot. There's no wind whatsoever. So we're looking forward to the dive that we're gonna have later on today in the ocean. All right, we're now in the mangrove part of Zanzibar. And although it's pretty full of tourists yet again, I always think that these kinds of areas are pretty magical because it's really like the crossing between land and sea, sweet water to salt water, the magic of these trees being able to grow in the water. I don't know, it's so bizarre. It has something magical, I think. We're escaping the crowd for a little bit. I don't know, it's really, Zanzibar is really like an island for the resorts and the organized tours. And we're not really those kinds of people. So now we're just going to stop having some lunch at the floating restaurant, which is awesome.
Switching to GoPro, we're taking the boat. Smile!
Again, the sun is currently setting and it's very nice. We're pretty smashed after this tour yet again, but it was absolutely wonderful. I really have the feeling that I'm getting to know the island a little bit better, and I just wanted to give Said a quick shout out. He was from Fisherman Tours and he was the most happy guy of the island, I think. But in general, I think the people here are very happy and very generous somehow. And I mean, the island is incredibly poor as well, but people constantly wave at you, smile at you, and that for me somehow really has that whole Africa vibe, you know? So all you can do as a tourist is be very touristy, do the tours, buy the local products, smile back as well, wave back as well, and chat with the locals as well. That's what we're currently doing, and I'm really, really loving the island. Yeah, I'm somehow very happy that we have a tropical island of which we can choose from in Africa, because I just love Africa. The vibe, the people, the nature as well. Although the nature here mainly is in the sea, I think.
Expedition. I didn't even vlog yet. It's just one
salty experience.
Very salty, blurry experience.
vlog at all today yet. We are now with Safari Blue, although for us it's a little bit more Safari Gray. We are basically on a snorkeling adventure. There's a lot of wind, so you might not hear me. Maybe I should go there. I think we're a little bit spoiled with snorkeling as well, because in Thailand the clear blue sea is really clear and blue, and over here it was a little bit blurry today. But still, a day like this is quite nice. We're having a little natural candy party here. So for instance, this was red banana, lychee, sweet mango, and this was jackfruit?
Yes, jackfruit.
And it all grows here, right?
Yeah, yeah, except dates.
Except the dates, yeah. Crazy baobab tree.
Our boomknuffelaar.
Natural pool. No fish to see here, unfortunately. So swimming only. Probably listening to Volbeat or something. What were you listening to?
Volbeat.
Yes! Alright guys, that was it for our summer, sunshine, sandy, salty hair, ocean air adventures in Zanzibar. I can't believe it. Time went too quick. So much to do. Way too little time. All in all, I just wanted to say that I really fell in love with this island. The people are enormously friendly and very, very happy. But in general, it's just like a tropical island in Africa is maybe the perfect combo, in my opinion. We didn't have enough time to do other things. So for example, if you're interested in seeing more wild dolphins, you can also just rent a boat and see them even more in a different spot on the island. But we've also heard amazing things about restaurant The Rock. Seriously, Google it. It's like the perfect Pinterest picture. And we didn't get the chance to see it. So we know one thing for sure, and that is that Zanzibar is perfectly fine to travel independently as well. So next time we're probably gonna do that. I just know one thing for sure, and that's that our adventures in Zanzibar aren't over yet. All in all, it's just an amazing island. So I don't wanna leave at all. But it's time to get back to work. So I wanna thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you in the next one. Bye.